Welcome to SV Union High School and Junior College.
In our last video or the previous video, we discussed about the 4-bit binary counter. Means it is a mod 16 type of counter in which we will get the pulses from 0 to 15. Means total 16 pulses should be there. And we already discussed about how to draw the diagram of 4-bit binary counter. Let's see how the 4-bit binary counter will work. Now, here it is a 4-bit binary counter and it is also known as a mod 16 counter, as we are getting here 16 pulses. Now, as the name suggests, it is a 4-bit binary counter. In this, we require 4 flip-flops. 1, 2, 3, 4 flip-flops are there and all the flip-flops are JK type. Now, here we are using the flip-flop JK, 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 JK. All the flip-flops are JK type. And we are giving here the triggering, means we are providing the clock pulses. As we already discussed about the working of JK flip-flop, how it will work, how it will give the triggering to that flip-flop, and according to the triggering, how it will give us the output. Now, here it is what? It is a negative edge trigger flip-flop. As it is a negative edge trigger flip-flop, basically what is the difference between positive edge triggering and negative edge triggering? The positive edge triggering means in which the output of the flip-flop will change at every positive edge. And what is the negative edge? Negative edge triggering means in which the flip-flop will give the output or changes the output at every negative edge. That is known as negative edge trigger flip-flop. Now here in this mod 16 counter, we are using negative edge trigger flip-flop. So this all the flip-flops are of which type? It is a negative edge trigger flip-flop, means the output changes for every negative edge. Okay, so for every negative edge we are getting the output. So see here, if we are giving this clock pulses, so in this clock pulses for every negative edge it will give us the output. Okay, now here see, as you see the diagram, in this diagram we are using one facility. That facility is known as a clear facility. What is meant by clear? Clear facility means it will clear all the flip-flops, or it can reset all the flip-flops. What is meant by reset? We can set all the flip-flops to 0000. That is known as the clear facility. So in this we are using the clear facility, that is CR. Okay, now as we are pressing, we are using here one switch. As we press this switch, by pressing the switch, we will get all the flip-flops clear. So we will get the output 0000. So at the first condition, QA, QB, QC and QD. This is what? This is the all, these are the all outputs of the 4 flip-flop. And as we press the clear input, clear terminal, the switch, then we will get here 0000. So all the flip-flops will set at 0000. So first of all the flip-flops are cleared and we will get 0000. Then what happens to the first clock pulse? As this first clock pulse will come, for each negative edge the flip-flop will toggles, means changes to the opposite state. So first of all, let's see the first condition. The first of all the flip-flops are set to what? All the flip-flops are set to 0000 by using clear facility. Now, as we are giving the input, that is the clock input, and this clock input in which we are using what? We are using the negative edge input. So here we are using the negative edge. Okay, so as the negative edge comes, so what happens for the first negative edge? So let's see, for the first negative edge, what happens? As we are giving the clock pulse and the first negative edge will appear, so for the first negative edge, this first flip-flop will toggle. And it toggle to what? It toggle to its opposite state. So, what is there in the first flip-flop? In the first flip-flop there is 0. Now, as the first clock pulse comes and when it gives the negative edge, when the negative edge comes, what happens? This first flip-flop will toggle, and toggle means what? It changes to from 0 to 1. Now here, what is safe? Here 0 is there. So, it changes from 0 to 1. So, we will get here the output 1. So, this 0 output changes to what? 1. Okay. Now, this 1 is what? the clocks are at 0000, then at the first clock pulse it changes to 0001, and we will get this output. So from this to this, it will give the output for its negative age. So for the first negative age, the flip flop gives us output 0001, and as we know, this is the binary equivalent of 1. What happens to the next clock pulse? So, as here, what is your 0001? What happens to the next clock pulse? As the next clock pulse will come, means the negative edge will be there. And what happens? The first flip flop will toggle. Toggle means what? It changes to opposite state. So, what is there in the first flip flop? The first flip flop having 1. Okay. Now, this 1 changes to what? This 1 turns to 0. Now this 1 turns to what? 0, because the this flip flop will toggle. Then this 0 comes where? This 0 comes out here. So we will make here 0. Okay. Now this 0 goes also where? This 0 goes to this second JK flip flop. And as we know, this 1 to 0, this it is a negative type of change. And that's why it is a negative edge triggered flip flop. So we will get this flip flop also, the second flip flop, that is B, also toggles, and we will get here it turns from 0 to 1. So here we got at the terminal QB, we got here 1. Okay. Now this 1 is where? At the QB position. So this QB goes where? This QB goes to the next clock pulse. Okay. As it goes to the next clock pulse, this again, this is a negative edge triggering, but we are getting what? We are getting here 1. So it is a positive chain, that's why this flip flop will not toggle, and we will get the same output. That's why the 0 comes out here, and this 0 also comes out here. So we will get 0010. So for the next clock pulse, what we will get? We will get here 0010. So 0010. This is the output of the next clock pulse. Okay? And as we know, we are getting the output or changing the output at every negative age. Okay, so in this way it is working. First of all, it having the output, it having the 0000, then it changes to 0001, then it changes to 0010. So as we know, this is the binary equivalent of 0, this is the binary equivalent of 1, and this is the binary equivalent of 2. In this way, we have to count the pulses and we will get the pulses from 0 to 15, because as the same as mod 16 counter. So in this mod 16 counter, we are giving the pulses, we are giving here the clock input, and as the clock input comes to this, all the fifth clocks, it will changes, it will toggles to the output, and we will get a different output. And for this output, we are getting the output from 000 to 0001, then 00010. Like that, we will get the output from 000 to 1111, means from 0 to 15. So total 16 pulses it will count, and it will work like that only as we are giving the clock pulses, as the clock pulses will enter over here, and for each negative edge it will toggles and gives us the output. So the all the for each negative edge, when a negative change is there, then the flip flop will toggles and it will gives us the output. So we will get the output from 000 to 1111. In this way, this 4-bit binary counter will work, and as it is a 4-bit binary counter, we require 4 flip-flops, and these are the 16 waveform. That's why it is also known as a mod 16 counter. So as by using this all JK flip-flop, we can construct the mod 16 counter, and in which we are using the JK flip-flop in toggle mode. So this is all about mod 16 counter or 4-bit binary counter. Now let's see how to write down the truth table of 4-bit binary counter. As we know, it is a 4-bit binary counter, so there are 4 inputs are there, A, B, C, D. All the 4 inputs are there. Okay. Now we have to give the clock pulses. So what happens to each clock pulse? So for each clock pulse, we have to write down the output. Okay. So this is the clock pulse. As we are giving the clock pulse, for the first clock pulse, as it is 0, so the output is what? 0, 0, 0, as we are resetting the flip flop. Okay. Now, this is 0, 0, 0. Now for the first clock pulse, what happens? As the first clock pulse will come in 0, 0, 0, 1. For the second clock pulse, what becomes? For the second clock pulse, it becomes 0, 0, 1, 0. Then for the next clock pulse, it will give us output 0, 0, 1, 1. So like that, this process is continuous till what? Till the 15th clock pulse. So for the 15th clock pulse, at the 15th pulse, what happens? At the 15th pulse, it will get the output 1, 1, 1, 1. And after this 15th pulse, what happens? When the 16th pulse or the next pulse will come, the flip-flop will reset. In this way, we will get the output from 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, 1. That's why it's known as a mod 16 count.